Hello students, today we are going to study Chapter 1, Chemical Reactions and Equations, Part 3, Class 10th, CBSE. Moving further, now we are going to study the balancing of equations. Now, what is meant by balancing of chemical equations? It is actually the method of making the number of atoms of different elements on both sides of the equation equal. So now, there are two methods of balancing an equation. First is the stepwise balancing and second one is quick balancing. Now first one, that is stepwise balancing. Let us take an example of a chemical equation. Sodium plus water. It will give sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen. Now, what are the methods to balance this chemical equation? Now, step one. Firstly, we have given the chemical equation in the form of word equation. We have to convert this word equation into symbol equation. Now, sodium. The symbol of sodium is Na, water, H2O, sodium hydroxide, NaOH, and hydrogen, H2. So, step one was converting the word equation into symbol equation. Now, step second. In step second, we have to count the number of atoms of all the elements in the reactants and the products on both sides of the equation. So, step second was, we have three elements here, Na, H2 and O. So, elements are Na, H, that is hydrogen, and O, oxygen. Now, on left side of the equation, number of atoms of Na, that is only one on left hand side, and of H, that is two, O, only one. Now moving to the right hand side, on the right side, number of atoms of sodium is only one, that of O is also one, but hydrogen has three number of atoms, two here and one here. So total number of atoms of hydrogen are three. So here we can see that the number of atoms of sodium on both sides of the equation are equal, that is one and one. Also, oxygen is balanced on both sides of the equation. So we have to balance hydrogen. So now we came to know that we have to balance hydrogen element on both sides of the equation. So we had the equation Na plus H2O, NaOH plus H2. So now to balance hydrogen atom on both sides of the equation, we have to multiply H2O, that is water, with 2. Now multiplying it with 2, here the number of atoms of hydrogen increases to 4, that is 2 into 2, 4, and also the number of atoms of oxygen changes to 2. So again, to make it balanced on both sides of the equation, we have to multiply Na and NaOH with 2. If we multiply Na with 2 and NaOH with 2, what we came to see? Now, the number of atoms of sodium on both sides of the equation are equal, that is 2 and 2. Also, the number of atoms of hydrogen are equal. Here is 2 and here is also 2, that is total 4. Here is also total 4. So again it is balanced. And last one, that is oxygen, here the number of atoms of oxygen are 2 and here it is also 2. So hence the whole equation gets balanced. So the balanced equation is 2Na plus 2H2O gives 2NaOH plus H2. Now here comes a question in our mind that why there is a need to balance such equations. Now need what is the need to balance these equations is to follow the law of conservation of mass which we have studied in class 9. That is, the mass can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. So to follow the law of conservation of mass, we need to balance these chemical equations. Now moving to next method of balancing, that is quick balancing. Let us take an example of an equation, that is phosphorus pentachloride, that is PCl5 plus water H2O gives phosphoric acid, that is H3PO4 plus hydrogen chloride, that is HCl. What is the quick method of balancing this equation? Let us take a variable A before PCl5, B before H2O, C before H3PO4 and D before HCl. So now make a table. Here make 3 columns, first for elements, then left of the equation, right of the equation. Here in the equation we have 4 elements. First is P, phosphorus, next is Cl, chloride, third is H, hydrogen, and next one is O, oxygen. On the left side we know that the number of atoms of P is A, because here is 1 and multiplying A with 1 will become A. Now on the right hand side it is C multiplied by 1, that is C. So it indicates that A is equals to C. Then Cl, here it is 5A, and on the right hand side it is D, because here it has only 1 atom, so 1 multiplied by D is D. So 5A is equals to D. Now next one, hydrogen. Here is B and here is 2, so 2 into B. And on the right hand side it is 3C plus, it is 1 and 1 multiplied by D, D. So 3C plus D. For oxygen, here it is B and here it is 4 multiplied by C, that is 4C. So here 2B is equals to 3C plus D and B is equals to 4C. So now substituting the value of B in this equation, so it will become 2 multiplied by 4C is equals to 3C plus D. It will become 8C is equals to 3C plus D, that is 5C is equals to D. Also D is equals to 5A, so 5A is equals to 5C, cancelling 5 with 5, it will become A is equals to C and it is also formed. So this means that one single equation satisfy all other 3. So now D is equals to 5C, put C is equals to 1, therefore D is equals to 5, A will also be equal to 1 and B will be equal to 4C, and here C is equals to 1, therefore it will become 4. Therefore, what will be the equation? PCl5, A is 1 plus B is 4, that is 4H2O will give, here is C and C is 1, that is H3PO4 plus D is 5, that is 5HCl. So here we can see that hydrogen has 4 into 2, 8. Here it also has 8. Here is 3 and here is 5. So in this way, our equation can be balanced in a quick and easy method. So for next parts, do watch our next videos.